keep the spirit of unity in the body.
Oh, yeah.
There is one body and one spirit.
That's just clear.
You were called. Who? All believers.
Huh?
You were called in one hope of your calling. Your calling. So everyone has a calling. He did not say a few pastors are going to arise and I'm going to draw people to their churches. He said all of my people in various sectors of society, in various neighborhoods, in various occupations, in various schools are going to rise all over the place. And my glory is going to be seen and people are going to be drawn to them everywhere. This is what God's called. Not just what we call an attractional model of church, to where everybody just invites somebody to come to church and they hear the great looking pastor up in the front. I have a word of knowledge that somebody thought, that ain't gonna work for us. Shut up. No, but that's an attractional model, is that we just do church really good, and then everybody invites people to church. Listen, there's nothing wrong with that. Many people have been born again that way. But in this day and age, that is not the primary model. That can be a part of it. But God's strategy is that everybody sitting in church is being equipped by the fivefold ministers. And the fivefold ministers are not trying to do the work of the ministry to touch everybody's lives, but the fivefold ministers are equipping people, and everybody's coming in not to give their little nod to God for the week, and then I go back to my thing, because that was Pastor Jerry's thing, Pastor Carl's thing, Pastor David's thing, and so on. No, they're coming in because their thing is to be a minister of the gospel, and they're coming in to be equipped so they can go out all week long and shine the light of the Lord and have people drawn to them to come to the Lord. See, and then you come back here in here to get equipped again. Everybody see what I'm talking about? Listen, this is not on most people's minds. Most people come to church, and now we got that over with, and now I go do my thing. And the Lord's saying, no, this is your thing. I'm calling you into ministry. I'm calling you into ministry. Now, this is the first part of a five-part series called It's Time to Arise, and I am very excited to share this new series with you. And clearly, it is time to arise. Isaiah 60 verses 1 and 2 say, arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and deep darkness the people, and we see that happening. But the Lord will arise over you, and his glory will be seen upon you. Now notice this. He didn't say, you should have arisen, but you missed your opportunity. No, he said, arise, meaning it's not too late. Get up right now. Arise. Do what I've called you to do. So now is the time. And you, yes, you, are the one that God's talking to. But notice this. He also said, the Lord will arise over you. He said that he's going to do his work through you. He's going to shine his glory upon you. And that glory includes his power,